Hello. Hi, I'm Patricia McNeely. I am an illumined Blu-ray twin flame from Chicago, Illinois. How are you? How is everybody doing? I hope you're doing well. So we've had some significant events, and recently we had this thing called the 12-12 portal. We had a new moon, and I didn't do a video for that. I want to do a video for you going forward. You know, what do these things represent, and what are you being able to expect going forward? So what you are expecting, if first and foremost, if you are a twin flame, if you've met your twin, even if you're not together, if you even suspect you're a twin flame, especially if you're a Blu-ray or think you are, if you are a golden ray of the golden sun, which is a new earth person, in which case you are both blue and golden. And yes, some people might say, you know what, I don't really get it about those rays. It's okay. Only you will really be able to confirm from the inside who you are. Okay? And I want to talk to you about some of the things about who you are, because this is where you diverge from things. And there's going to be a lot that happens going forward. There will be people you say bye-bye to. Bye now, bye. We're parting ways, and it's going to continue, and it may feel lonely for some of you. This time of year in December are the holidays for a lot of you. So there's a lot of people who've either been celebrating Eid, if you're Muslim, Hanukkah, if you're Jewish. Buddhists have a holiday coming up that celebrates the Bodhi tree. And if you were raised in any way, shape, or form as Christian, or you live in a culture that's predominantly Christian, you got Christmas coming up. But the origin of a lot of this is celebrating the light. And this brings you back to a lot of the, what people would call earth religions, you know, way beyond times before some of that stuff was formed. And that's what I want to talk to you about is, yes, it is a time for the light. We are coming up to the solstice, and it's time for action. These actions are you holding the light. You have to be able to hold the light. Furthermore, it is acknowledgement that both you and your twin flame are the light and the love. Easier said than done, especially if you've been seeing some not so nice behaviors, or if you feel stuck. It's really hard to acknowledge that some of this is, you know, happening the way it's happening. And it can be discouraging. So I want to encourage you that those of you who truly have been persistent, acknowledging it, even on the days when you don't know what to do, it's still here. Nothing has stopped. Your twin isn't going away. You can't cut it out. It always grows back. It will always grow back, and it's not an it. It's your twin flame. It's the love and the light. You can't cut it out. So some of the things we're going to talk about here, what are you creating for this full moon? Because a lot of people go in, you know, they'll go do things for new moon. They'll do a ritual. They'll do a ceremony. They'll make wishes. They delve deep into that black velvety energy, that loamy velvety dirt, earth, womb, creative energy. And they will want wishes to come true. But what happens is, as you are wishing, as other people are wishing, there's a lot of backwash. There's a lot of tangly mess. And there will be things that feel like they go bump in the night. A lot of people are experiencing the weirdnesses of the collective mental body. It's just weird. It can feel like space madness. It can feel like, you know, just like it doesn't belong to you and you don't want anymore. And that's normal, but that is not your norm. That is not where you are intended to live. We're coming up to the solstice. Again, this is an equalizer, equal light and darkness. And yeah, Northern Hemisphere and Southern Hemisphere, you know, we're This is the longest night of the year, the 21st. Also, I was reminded of this when I went looking at cards, greeting cards. Hanukkah. What's the message of Hanukkah? It's the miraculous light that burned. It's a thing that just kept burning and burning and burning and burning and burning. I don't know if you can really see it there, but right at the hottest part, that blue white. As a child, I was absolutely fascinated with the pilot light in the stove because it was that electric blue. And I could peek inside the edge and just stare at it. And, you know, that's just one of my things. Maybe you've had something equivalent. But I didn't know back then it was because, you know, blue had some significance. I've always been drawn to blue. Today I'm wearing green. Green is the color of healing and compassion. And yes, the healing will continue. Being compassionate and kind about it with each other, but especially your true love. So you are celebrating the light burning within no matter what you're celebrating this time of year. You're also bringing in and holding the light and love together. If you have not unified yourself, if you are not approaching this as though you are one unit, one soul, get to that point. Really get to that point. If you're continuing to separate yourself, then that's on you. It's not because I haven't presented tools out there to use for it or talked about. You have to hold the light and love together. It's time for you to be in your physical union. For those of you, and a lot of you might be the blue rays, you have actually been able to hold this sense of being in union or your union for some time, and you're saying, well, it's about time now that we get this together. And there may be reasons that you have been a part of agreements that you're finishing up or high-level agreement. So when I say divergence, this is where the rubber meets the road. This is where you're going to pick the high road or you're going to pick the flat road. You're going to pick the low road or you're going to pick the high road. I encourage you pick the high road because that is where you're going to zip line over these portals of everybody else's crud. This is where you're going to disentangle yourself. And just to let you know, a lot of it out there is like having spaghetti in your head. Your whole third eye is cluttered up with spaghetti. Your eyes are cluttered up. Your heart chakra, your universal chakra, it's like a tangly mess of all these wires and connections to other people. And you don't want any more. Your union is not here to hold all of these other people, places, things. It's here to hold each other. You're holding the light and love within each other. It is within. And there are important connection points within your twin flame. A lot of that, the male-bodied twin flames. Those who are holders of the masculine, the high divine, brand new divine masculine, electric and magnetic, and men. And when I talk to men in the sessions, men are fully aware of doing a lot of things. But in a human way, you know, everyone is balancing their human sides. You know, balancing being human and balancing being the high human angelic and the willingness to hold the light and love within. We're also coming up to the full moon, which coincides with Christmas Day, December 25th. It is called the Long Night's Moon in some traditions. It is a time that I hope that you're hibernating with your twin. I wish that for everybody. I honestly hope you're not laying on a floor in some meditation and that you're actually in the privacy of your own room with your true twin flame. Also, this has been a big wish for people, that people who drink, smoke, drug will come home. And the drugs could be both pharmaceutical, it could be like antidepressants, anti-anxiety, anything that affects your union. a lot of it recreational drug use, or if somehow your twin has gotten into trouble through recreational drug use, if it is alcohol, and, you know, again, only you will know what is the extent of it in your union. This is your true love story. But what I can tell you is that as someone who has lived through getting sober, and yes, it took years, the pathways are cut now. If you're not expecting to do these things in a brand new way and trusting that new ways have been created and sticking your toe in the water and trying, you won't know what I'm talking about. What some of you will find is that things have been made easier and effortless. But it's up to you to transcend the karmic baloney with sweetness together. And I want to give you some sort of an illustration of what some of this is like for you. Okay, this may be what your twin has been stuck in. You could call that a house, a marriage, organizations like a union or a military organization. It could be professional. It could be that they are a workaholic, okay? And what happens? Well, we've had all of this watery energy come in to wash out all of the emotions, all of that spaghetti that's been cluttering up your heart space, your head space, your eye space, washing it out, and you still have to get your twin unstuck. So you're essentially taking them, you know, and just like anything, they're root bound. See those roots? Those roots right there. You have to finish the job of unrooting them from wherever they've been stuck and holding them, pulling them into your heart. Because your love's not here to live in a pot this size. Your love is here for expansion and going back out into creation, out into the universe. And I think a lot of us would agree, no matter what country you live in, no matter what culture you come from, no matter what your family lineage is that a lot of the stuff here, it really isn't really where we want to live. And even if you don't know where it is that you truly live or what you've once called home, you know it's got to be better than this. You do know that. It's a knowingness inside your heart. And don't give in to the resignation and the futility that's out there. There are people feeling very futile, and yet I will say to you that some of them, while they may not know how, are not making an effort. They are just simply throwing up their hands or commiserating or, you know, going out to see what all of the other children on the playground are doing. You can't look to others for your true love story. You can't. You have to stick to your own true love story because it is from the inside out. It is from the light and love within. The light burning within you is how you feel what your next moves are, how you feel your twin across the miles, how you feel connected to everything that is a light in this entire universe, and then some. There is light. There is light in things. And some of you get derailed by some of the things that are set out there. You may not know what to do. There are things to do. There really are. Okay, so what you have is the usual rush of energy or usual rush of creative energy, which will tend to make people feel urgent, anxious, maybe a feeling that you're not doing it right or something's off or somehow you've wronged something and how do you fix it or correct it. And there are things to be said. Transcending the karma has to be done with sweetness. And I even get signals about the sweetness. I have here, this is some honey that I got from an urban farm. And for those of you who I've spoken to, you know, and you may or may not know Chicago, but I live in an urban area. I'm about 2 miles, 2.5 miles from O'Hare International Airport. And so the houses are rather close. They're, you know, this is not farm country. But 2 years ago, my mother stopped by my house. And yes, there's my mom. A lot of you have mothers. And whether you have a good or a bad relationship with your mom, please know it can always get better. My mom stopped by my house and gave me a gift of honey. And she said she was just driving and these people had it. Well, I went to go take my computer in and I walked back, a beautiful, gorgeous day, and the honey was out on a table for sale. And I tried to find the gentleman so that I could say, hey, you know, I want to buy some honey, let me give you the money. So I go in the back and I say, hello, hello, hello. And he comes out and I say, I want to buy one of these bottles of honey and give you the money. And he says, did you ever see the beehives? And I said, no. He goes, do you want to see them? So he invited me in the backyard. And at first I was a little leery. I said, okay, here I am in the backyard of this gentleman. And what he showed me, he had a bench there. He had 4 hives. But he told me about not just the honey, because we've had some brutal winters. He lost a hive last year. The bees froze, and the insulation didn't help. You can't relocate them. You can't bring them inside. They hibernate. And he lost some. So he got another hive, and there it has a new queen. And the queen gets busy just making babies. Babies, 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 babies. And there are nurse bees. And I learned a lot. It was like a little field trip when you're in biology class. So the nurses, as soon as the babies are born, they get them out. They clean out the little cell in the hive. And then they go and the bees start to learn to fly. Now, here's where it was my message. The baby bees go out about 4 feet from the hive. And they go back, and they go out, and they go back. And they do this for about a week to a week and a half until they are honed in on where is their home. And the message for me was the new people, the new souls, or the baby souls, or the people that are here to receive their light body, you will be flying. You will be going slightly out of body and back in. You need to hold you and your twin together. And this is one of the differences between me and some of the other twin flame people out there talking. Okay, nothing against anyone else. But it's like we all have our special little niche. Some people talk about emotions. Some people talk about meditations. I am the person who talks about ascension and resurrection and flying. Okay, up until now, starting from last year, all of my material that is for sale on my website, yes, my webinars, and yes, I would be a fool if I didn't say that it is available. Starting from the very beginning one on how the runner will return, telling you step by step, leading you through opening your channels, clearing out. You want to clear out all of the old connections, all of this old tangled up spaghetti of what's been connected in your heart, your third eye, your eye, your head, your twin flame's head. Some of you have, you need a reminder that you're not just doing this for you. You're able to do it on behalf of you and your twin from the inside out, from within. The light burning within. The light burning from within. Yes, it's from within and it is outside. Anything that you would consider to be spiritual or spirit into matter will always be inside and then out and in and out. And yes, it's a correlation would be birth contractions, giving birth. There's a couple things that I want to let you know about which need clarity, and I want to say this out loud to please pay attention, that Kundalini rushes go from your pelvis up the spine, sometimes up will seem like it shoots through your skull. any other kind of rush, if it is especially feeling like sexual energy in your private part area, in your sexual organs, whether it's inside like the prostate or outside like on your private parts that you would, use intimately with someone else or yourself, if you are feeling rushes there, that is old strings of connection. And yeah, a tangled up mess of everyone you probably have ever been with or your twin has been with. If you keep it down there, that's where it stays. If you bring it up, that's what you need to do. So if you are getting further with this, you will feel the difference. If you don't know what to do, I have tools for that. And yes, they're available in several webinars. They are. The other thing to mention to you is there is talk yet again, every time we go through these portals, every time we go through a season, of people saying, well, it's not for this lifetime. Bye now. That's up to you if that's your belief. I'm not going to be here, convincing you. You're going to know the truth. And if also you have other people telling you, I very much encourage you, get within yourself, because other people won't know. Your family and friends around you, they will probably want what's best for you. They won't want to see you get hurt. It's that simple. Just like maybe on your twin side, your twin's family or friends may not want to see them go through certain things. Get the strings of connection to other people out of your union space. And yes, your body will be the best instrument that you have. Your body over the forever is going to be your best friend, right after your twin flame. Your twin flame is your best forever friend. And you better really make it so that you really feel it naturally that you want to have each other's back. This is not a one-way street. Again, some of you are going to be like the little bees that have made this honey, where you practice going in and out. I talked to people already who have been experiencing some of the out-of-body experiences with their twin. Part of the reason this is taking so long is so that you don't have a nervous breakdown and that your twin flame doesn't freak out with it. It's that simple. It really is that simple, because the fears that have accumulated in the head, in the mental body, in the emotional body, in the mental emotional body, amplified by the ego saying certain things to you like, oh, better look out for that person, or that thing's dark, or, run for the hills. Or what happens at almost every season with the economy. Oh, the economy. I get absolutely appalled at what people say about the economy, because there is so much abundance in the world. Yeah, it's out of balance. It is out of balance. Who's going to bring it into balance? The twin flames. Twin flames are what equalize and balance. It is the love that equalizes everything in the world. It only starts at home in your heart. You stop the war by getting peaceful in your heart. That's where it starts. Peace and harmony. The love is in there. The light is in there. The joy follows. The exuberance. The vivaciousness. And some of, I saw this thing recently. You might know Nike, where they say, just do it. Just do it. Just do it. Just do it. And it was a t-shirt that was just like, oh, let someone else do it. Somebody else isn't going to do this. You have to do it. You're the only one with the connections. You're the only one who can hold. And this is how it works, that during these portals, when wishes come true, and you in your physical life and you recognize the things that need to be let go of, and you're like, oh, gee, I wasn't feeling that before, and you have to ask to get it out. There are ways to get it out. I actually have some very easy physical exercises to help you get this out and relieve it, release it. A lot of you would like release. Face it, you would. You'd really like to get back to living and have some of this stop being so much work. And I'm really sorry that it's work. When I was first woken up, which is several years ago, and I had workshops, I would have people show up at the workshop thinking it was a singles club. And this is not a singles thing, it's not a dating thing. Because if it were, you'd be putting in your order for, you know, well, I want the person to look like this, and I want it to be like that, and I want it to be like this, and I want it. But what you're getting is the ability to transcend the karma through all of the connections that you each have, cut it in half, cut to the chase, get going, get back to being the light and the love, and go home from whence you came and where you really belong. Be home with each other. That means living with each other. It does. And how do you get out of the mode of, well, you know, my twin prefers to live in such a manner or prefers this lifestyle, or my twin prefers to hop back into that marriage or that relationship? Try out my July and September webinars. That's where I talk about of the how-to. How do you keep it moving? You have the ability to transmute things. All of these things are transition into new. It's continually a new life. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. Have you ever heard that one? I didn't make that up. But people say it, and it will feel like that to you on some days. It will feel absolutely new. It will feel new to you with your twin as though everything is exciting again. The transcendence, rising above it. How do you rise above some of the stuff? Well, I'll tell you one thing. If you're going back to your high school physics and you're doing every action has an equal and opposite reaction, and you're doing the same things to your twin that you think they're doing to you, knock it off. That's the best thing I can say. Stop it, because you can't shove each other. That doesn't work. It does start within so that it shows up on the outside. You want it in every level of physical living. This is one level. The fifth dimension is another level. And those of you who actually do have your twin with you, this is bonus time. And the challenge is going to be hold steady for each other. Sometimes it might be your turn, sometimes it might be their turn. You may have to agree to disagree. Focus on each other. It really does take you putting your twin first in everything and letting go of other things. The last thing that I'll say is that this is intended to be a very happy time, especially for the Blu-ray twin flames. You've been long suffering. A lot of you have been ill. It is duly noted. It is noticed. There's people I talk to where the disparity between it's a couple. It's a unit, and yet one twin is here and the other one's here. One is rich, the other one's on disability. One's in this space, one's in that space. You cannot merge with each other if there are other people's energies in your union. It's that simple. It will only go so far. And it's up to you to take the physical actions to remove yourself or remove the obstacle from your union space. The focus is on union because this is how you do everything together. It's how you complement each other. It's how you create together. It is how you are able to be together. None of you is, if you're twin flame, none of you is the Lone Ranger. If you are a divine counterpart, you still have your other, and your brand new life will be with your other. Twin flames do have a bit more of a challenge. If you suspect that someone with you is a false energy, you have to feel that in your heart. If you don't know, if you are confused because you're too in the situation to really be able to tell, go to my website and order a session. That is one of the things that I help people with is discernment. We get right into it. We get some of your energies cleared so that you are able to discern for yourself. You're expected to continue here where you are more and more self-empowered. It's you pulling what is necessary and needed, anything really, from your union. Thank you so much for watching, and I will have my website here in this video and down below. I wish everyone a very happy light celebration, whatever it is you are celebrating. Don't forget your twin. Get them some small token of something from your heart. Don't, you know, it has to be you being big-hearted, because you do, I know a lot of you, you're very sweet and you have huge hearts. Don't forget your twin. Your heart is too precious to be broken. And have a wonderful celebration. Last day of Hanukkah, solstice, the Bodhi celebration. The road to enlightenment is not by living by yourself. You're already enlightened. Get more connected. Get it deeper and deeper and deeper, and feel it and have each other, because you will. Thank you so much. And lots more stuff coming up, so I will check you next time. Have a wonderful week. Bye now.